Hi everyone and welcome back to the Organized Notebook. In this video, we wanted to show you a tour of our Ghibli-themed student planner. This template is a great way to stay organized for school, and if you're interested in this, we'll leave the link to the template in our store. We also have a bunch of other different student planner themes that you can check out as well. So let's get started. First, let's do a quick main overview of this template. So when you open it, you'll notice that there are main sections such as my courses, my assignments and exams, and you can see everything by this week, today, tomorrow, and not done. And then we have your notes here, and these also have handy tabs like need to review, reviewed, by tag, and by course. And then there is my planner as well, and you can add your personal schedule here, as well as your assignments and exams. So let's dive into my courses because this is where we recommend how you would use this template. So you would just need to add courses here that you're taking at the moment, and everything is going to be saved into its respective databases, which we've also added as quick links. So if we just go here and click plus new, let's say that we're going to take a beginner Spanish class. You could put the start and end date by clicking end date and choosing it from the calendar. So let's say that this course goes until the 14th of December, and you can choose the classroom. So if you need a way to track where your room is, this is also very handy, and also the course schedule. So if this class meets Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, you can do that as well. And you can also add what school it's at if you're taking multiple courses in different schools. And at the end, you can add the final grade, and you can also add the teacher from your contacts as well. So you'll see that it's contact 1, contact 2, and contact 3 is all from this contacts database. So if you wanted to create a new teacher here, you could add contact 4 and plus new contact in contacts like this. And then you can actually just click template course, and this is going to load everything you need in this course. And it's all going to be linked to the main course that you've created here. So now if we go here, you'll see that there's these assignments, exams, and schedules, and you can see only assignments, and you could also see only exams like this. So let's just, for example, add a sample exam. So if we have a final exam, and we already know that the date is going to be on December 1st, and you could add a description and whether or not it's done. And if we open it, you can see that you can choose between schedule, exam, assignment. So this is an exam, so you could click exam, and it's going to load an exam template here. So it's going to ask you, what do I need to study, a to-do list, and resources you can add here to save for your final exam. So if we go here, then now we have our final exam in here. And next we have a section for notes. And actually, we recommend you to open this in full page whenever you use this, just so that you can really get the most out of just going through everything inside the course. And if we just click here plus new, you can add a new note. So let's say that this is our first class note, and we open it up and we're about to take notes. Well, now we have some handy note templates. So we have a default, meeting, Cornell, and outline. So let's say we want to take notes using Cornell method. You can just click that. And we'll even have a handy feature where it's going to show you the created date and last edited time. And here you could just start taking notes immediately while you're in your class. And next we have our to-do list. So let's say that our first assignment in this beginner Spanish class is just to review some vocabulary. So we can actually just click plus new here and review vocab. And it already tags it to beginner Spanish class. So if we have this, you could actually just control click and you can copy the link. And then you could add it here to this part by pasting it in, and you can mention the page. So if you had an assignment here, you could actually just attach it like that. And you can also add the date and the priority. Next, we also have flashcard decks, and these are super useful because you could just add vocab flashcards. So if we have Spanish Unit 1 vocab and we open it up, then you'll see that we have this nice template for flashcards. And all you have to do, for example, is to put how to say hello. And you would type the answer here. So you would say hola. And then if we go back to our flashcard, you'll see here how to say hello. And then you can test yourself by showing the answer like this. So this is a really handy way to make flashcards in Notion. And you can move it to review again or learn depending on where you are with this. And each deck you can just plus new to add a new deck. Next, we have the resources and documents. So here you can add things like online textbooks, syllabus, and so on. So if we click plus new here, you could just put online textbook and you can tag it as a textbook and add the URL, files and media, and so on. And then in this section, you can start tracking your grades. So let's say that we have a pop quiz and your score was 10 out of 12. It's going to calculate the percentage for you. You could add the date and you could even add the actual file to the quiz if you need to. And this is a really good way to keep track of your grades because sometimes teachers can make mistakes. And if you have all of your data here stored like this, you also have a good idea of what your final grade could be. So we added this feature as well. And then now we have contacts here. So if we go here to contacts, you can do plus new. And let's say that you have a classmate that you like to share notes with. So then you could do classmate one and you could tag it as a classmate. You could add their phone number, email, notes, URL, and you could even click this new contact here so that you can load this icon for it. And now we basically have filled in our beginner Spanish class course. And as you can see, the teacher here is not reflected in our contacts for this. So you actually have to make sure to tag it with the beginner Spanish class. So it's better if you add the teacher here first and then you choose from the list here. But if you want to add it here first, you can go to contacts and then you can click here to add this contact to the beginner Spanish class. And then if you go down, you'll notice that contact 4 is here now, and you could also load this one to get the icon. So now let's take a look at how this is all reflected inside our main student planner. So if we go back now to our student planner, we'll see that it appears here, our beginner Spanish class, and it includes all of these information that we added, all conveniently on the front page. And we've also designed this so that it only shows the current courses. So if we go to courses here, you can see past courses and view all. So if we go back, then you can see that we have not done here the final exam for beginner Spanish class that we already added through the course. So this is just going to show you everything you need to do. And then if we go to notes, you'll also see the class note that we just added as well. And you could click by course and you'll see it by course. And then in my planner, if we go to December, you see the final exam showing up here. And if you want to show your personal schedule, you can also do it here. For example, like if you have a student club, you could put student club meeting and it's going to be tagged as a schedule. So we basically have three different categories for your calendar, which are assignment, exam, and schedule. So this is only going to show you your personal schedules. And then you can see that all of these databases that we added information to can be accessed through the quick links. And we don't really recommend changing the content inside the quick links, but rather doing everything through the courses just so that everything is tagged correctly. But let's say that we want to go to the contacts list. You can now see that we've added it conveniently here. And you can also do gallery view so that if you need to remember people's faces, then this could be a useful way to do that. And we also have table view, so you can see that we just added classmate one to beginner Spanish class, and we also added the teacher to our beginner Spanish class. And in the notes, you can also add things like their office hours and so on. So this can be super useful. So that was our tour of the Ghibli theme inspired student planner. We hope that this was useful for you to see how you can use Notion for school. And if you're interested in purchasing this template, we'll leave the link to that in the description below. And we have a bunch of other themes available, so we highly recommend you to check those out. And if you have any questions, comments, or anything that was confusing in this video, feel free to let us know, and we'll see you in the next one.